It looks like Moby Point. It's terrific. I won't, Mom. As long as you let me go. I believe. I can't do it.
You can.
No, I can't. Why did you listen to Jefferson today?
Yes, your interviewer from Jefferson, Mr. Kessler, is here. I was supposed to be here at 3. The traffic was bumper to bumper with every drooling, mouth-breathing bottom feeder from here to Minneapolis going to football games. Mindless torture. It's going to take me at least 2 hours to assess your qualifications and analyze your work. I assume you're not going anywhere.
We always dress for dinner.
So, you want to attend Jefferson? That's not difficult to understand. We have an exceptional program. I went there myself when I was your age. It's a rewarding experience with obvious benefits. Now, if I could see your science experiments, Mr. Bethune. Do you have a science experiment, Mr. Bethune?
Yes. Yes, I do.
May I see it?
You're looking at it.
Is this a joke, Mr. Bethune?
No. I'm hoping to prove that within every normal system, there exists an aberration. Something different.
The chaos theory.
The Bethune theory.
Your hypothesis?
When a small abnormal element is forced into a larger normal system, the element will either be rejected or destroyed.
Obviously.
But it doesn't have to be that way. If...
If...
If the element is brave.
Brave.
The element can hold out long enough and face the torment of the system until the system's energy is depleted. If the element can look the system in the eye and say, I'm still here, asshole, then the system will have to change, adapt, mutate. And if this happens, it'll prove my fucking point.
Which is what?
There is no normal. Angus, where are you going? Mutate.